welcome to this video. Now today I'm going to be doing a top 10 list. I'm going to be doing my top 10 songs by Prefab Sprout. So a fantastic band. I've maybe over the last 4 or 5 months, I'd say, really gotten into them. Like, I've always been aware of them, like, for maybe like the last couple of years, but always, I guess, a bit ignored them a little bit compared to like sort of other bands, like off bands like around like that era, things like Loyal, like, and Smiths, I always sort of preferred. But certainly now I've really like got into them. Maybe they're slightly, I guess, difficult to get into, like, a little bit. Like, initially some of the songs can seem a bit too clever, a bit maybe too complex, like lyrically and kind of musically, kind of like doing slightly sort of weird, like sort of slightly like unconventional things. But kind of like, yeah, just like once that you get into them, like they're a really fantastic band. There's a lot of like great songs, like both the singles and also like sort of like some great album tracks as well across their releases. Like I said, I'll just be doing my personal top 10 songs of theirs. And the way I do this, I've done this with a couple of top 10 videos before, assuming that like I'm not flagged up like for copyright. That is, like, I'll put in like a little clip like off like the music video or like them doing like a live performance of it, just to make it like a bit more like interesting. So anyway, I will get started with my number 10 choice. Just look at us now. What adds up the way it did when we were young? Just look at us now. Things hurt more, much more than cars and girls. Which is going to go to the song Cars and Girls here, which I've got the 12-inch single for it here. This is a great song. It is very much lyrically a kind of sort of piss take on Bruce Springsteen, possibly, like, as you can tell by kind of like the single cover there, and basically about how all his songs were about kind of cars and girls and that, like, there's kind of more to life and there's sort of like more, and there's more important things like to worry about, like in like the world than that. But I think it's a very effective song at that. Like, it's not overtly so. It does actually mention Springsteen, like, by name, like, in it, like, as well, it is a song that, like, which I think probably, like, when most people hear it, they just think it is a song about cars and girls, but under the surface is actually a song kind of sort of like very much against having songs like only about that. So I kind of like that juxtaposition, like that kind of thing, like, happens like quite a bit, like with like Prefab Sprout songs, and this is certainly like a fine example of it. It's from the Langley Parks Memphis album. Not one of my favourite albums off theirs overall, but this is certainly for me one of the strongest songs on it. And it's quite like interesting to note as well that they had this song like kicking about at the same time they done the Steve McQueen album, like, because there's live performances of this like from 1985. So it's kind of like amazing to think that like they kind of passed up on this song and for that album. Like, but like, I'm glad they did, because they did a great version like on Langley Park, and that's the version which is my number 10 choice. I tried with sugar cubes and they're okay. Next up, number 9, I'm going for the song Wild Horses, which is from the Jordan the Comeback album. This is probably, I would say, the deepest cut was going to be like on like my list, possibly. Although I do think it was on the Best Of compilation, what came out in the early 90s. So, like, it might have been a single. Like, I'm almost certain that it wasn't, though. Wild Horses, a great song. It's the second track on here. And I guess it is a song which really grows on you. You know, the first time I heard this album, like, in general, I wasn't impressed, and it's probably what put me off getting more into Prefab Sprout. I mean this was about 5-6 years ago now. But certainly now, like, I do like and enjoy most of this album. It's not flawless. There are a couple of slightly dub tracks, but this certainly isn't one of them. Wild Horses, it's a really beautiful song. It's very synthesizer driven, this, and for me, it doesn't sound dated at all. It still sounds very contemporary. It's got this kind of lo-fi sort of feel to it, which you kind of still hear, like, that kind of thing, like, sort of going on, like, in that music today. And like, I love like the bit. I think it's just at the end of the verse where it kind of like the beat kind of sort of jutters a little bit. I think that sounds really clever, and like, it's certainly a kind of vibe which I think potentially went on to influence, maybe not directly, but certainly like this kind of sound, like is like quite like is still quite prevalent like in kind of music today. So I think like for that, and like the fact that it is a really lovely song, like McAloon sings it beautifully, and yeah, it's a really nice track there. So that's Wild Horses at number 9. Okay, next track up now I'm going for is Life of Surprises. Now, it was, like, I first heard it on this album, Protest Songs, but the song does have quite a complex history, because it originally came out as the B-side to this, Nightingales, and it is listed as a demo, like on the back, it's on the B-side, a demo tape, Life of Surprises, but it is the exact same version of what appears on this, and like was later then released as a single to promote the Greatest Hits album. So it was like, although it is, the song is technically, the recording is technically a demo, it still went on to be again, I think, a top 20 hit for them, like if not, I think like top 30, top 40 hit. But yeah, the song itself is really great. It's an upbeat song. Like it's a great single like off theirs, and I think a great kind of entry point like for like their career, because it's not the most kind of complex or kind of clever song like they ever did, like, but it's just a really nice track, and like, yeah, like always gets me singing along, like I'm like in like a good mood. So yeah, Life of Surprises will come in at number 8. Okay, next track up, at number 7 on my list, I'm giving it to The Golden Calf. So this is from the Langley Park to Memphis album, and for me, it is my favourite song on the record. It's a bit more of a kind of rock, like rocking song, this, with kind of slightly louder guitars and sort of bigger drums than maybe some of like the other material like on the album. But I think it is one of like their best songs. I think like McAloon, again, he sings it really well. It sounds a bit like Elton John in it. Like, I think certainly like Elton John in his kind of like Saturday Night All Rights for Fighting kind of like mode. But yeah, a really, really great rocking song. Interestingly, again, this was one of like their earlier compositions. It dates back to, I've read, 1979. They've had this kicking about since, like, which is like well before like the debut album like even came out. And then they just sort of like were like, when they were making Langley Park, thinking, oh, we maybe need something a bit more upbeat. And like, I'm so glad that like they like well like recorded it, because otherwise this song like would have been like lost forever. I mean, if I've got a slight complaint, it's maybe got one too many verses on it. But I mean, kind of like once like you listen to it, you kind of can just get sort of swept away in it. And like, I think it does work like as like a really good song. But yeah, Golden Calf, another fantastic track there, would be my number 7 choice. And I've lost just what it takes to be honest. You're after infrared instead of sun. You're after bubble gum. You give me a bad one for everyone. You give me a bad one for everyone. Next one up now, I'm giving it to Farron Young. This is the opening track on their classic album, Steve McQueen. I would say their best album. And this is a great song. It's a quite fast-paced track. This is kind of like the ideal album opener, really. Again, McAloon's vocals very powerful. And I just like it. Kind of, it does kind of have a kind of sort of band jam sort of feel to it. You've got like that kind of riff, what kind of goes through the song, and then like this extended outro, which normally I don't really like with songs, but there's just something about this one that I kind of like. I like the way different instruments sort of drop in and out, like on like the fade out of it. And like they do a great live version of it, like as well. So yeah, Farron Young, another brilliant song, will come in at number 6. Oh no. Don't blame me. Up now at number 5 on my list, I'm going for the song Don't Sing. It's the opening track on the album Swoon Here. So this was their first album, came out in 1984. And this probably, I would say for me, was the first song of theirs which I really listened to and really loved. Because it has, again, it's a bit more kind of guitar based, this one. You kind of got like that sort of guitar and like harmonica thing like going on like in it. Lyrically, I'm not too sure what it's about. It kind of sort of talks about like sort of like, oh no, don't blame Mexico. And I think there is some kind of narrative like to like the song, but yeah, possibly need to study it like a little bit like more. But yeah, it is a good song musically, like a really good song musically. And like again, the structure of it like is like quite interesting. And yeah, like talk about like, this album like as well. It is one which just recently has again really grown on me. Again, like when I first played it, aside from Don't Sing, I don't think I really cared for much of the other tracks. But yeah, like I said, like, just in that last couple of weeks, like be really like digging it. Great record like overall, but like a great opening track there, Don't Sing from the Swoon album. Depending on it. Next track up now at number 4 on my list, I'm giving it to the track Appetites. This is from, again, from Steve McQueen here. This is another classic song for me. Yeah, I think it's just like the perfect pop song, really, you know, kind of like the melody's really good, the production, Thomas Dolby's production, really clean on it. And like again, I love the way like again it's constructed, a bit more conventional verse chorus structure like on this one. But again, just the way that like the verse sort of leads into the chorus, that kind of build up to it, just works really well. Just keeps like the song going, gives it a lot of like momentum. So yeah, like Appetite for me would come at number 4. It wasn't a hit. It only reached I think number 92 on the UK charts, which is a it's just staggering to think that great songs like this kind of just kind of fell through kind of like commercially. Another great song though. Like Appetite would come in at number 4. You should be loving someone, and you know who it must be, 'cause you'll never find Atlantis till you make that someone me. Next one now at number 3, I'm going for Looking for Atlantis. This is the opening track on Jordan the Comeback. And again, this is another one which is probably been one of like the only songs of theirs which I guess I kind of liked again for like a very long time, you know, like when I first heard this album probably about I said 5-6 years ago, this is a song which really stood out and like it was like, wow, this is going to be a great album. But then it kind of then started to go downhill for me like a little bit like at like that time. Like, but this is a song like, which has always kind of stayed with me, and it's a fun track. It's like an upbeat song, the production on it's like again really classy, really clean. But again, it's still kind of fun and it's got a kind of playfulness like to it, which I guess maybe some of like their other material perhaps doesn't have. A really fantastic song, and yeah, like always, that will always been, like I said, like one of my favourites. So Looking for Atlantis comes in at number 3. I've got this friend who thinks he's in love with you, and it doesn't sum it up, he says singing the blues. And when I learn to walk in somebody else's shoes, he's screaming because he's found something to lose. Up now at number 2, I'm going for their first ever release, Lions in My Own Garden, Exit Someone. So this is their first single, and I did show this in my last vinyl update, but I've later found this is actually not an original pressing of it, like as I thought it was. This is actually because it originally came out on like their own record label. They had, I don't know how they had like their own record label, but like they did like in like their early days, and then they signed to Kitchenware Records. This is on Kitchenware, and this is basically just like those the first two singles, so Lions in My Own Garden and then The Devil Has All the Best Times, that was the second single. Again, neither of them done like anything commercially, but for me, Lions in My Own Garden is a amazing song, very cleverly constructed again, as it doesn't actually have a chorus to it, but it doesn't seem forced, you know, like a lot of songs like which I guess maybe say things like McCartney's done, like Uncle Albert and that, like where it where it is distinct sections of it. This one though, it is similar, but it just kind of flows a lot easier. Like, even though, like I said, it doesn't really like have a chorus and kind of sections which are just like kind of like there's a couple of bars or something, but then it doesn't kind of like reappear like later on. And I do like as well with this how instrumentally it is a lot rawer than some of like the other work. It's kind of just got a guitar, harmonica, bass, and drums, I think, on it. So it does have a kind of more kind of, I don't want to say punky sound to it, but that kind of punk influence, a kind of DIY, that sort of vibe to it, which they very quickly grew out of. Really great song, and for me, would be my number two choice.
All my silence and my strained respect. Chances in the same regrets. Kiss the thief and you save the reckless.
But now you're number one now, and it was a bit difficult, choosing like my favourite song of theirs, and I suppose this could possibly change, I guess, any off like the top like three or four like could probably like shift around. But I have decided to go for number one, the track Bonnie from Steve McQueen. Now this was not a single at all. I think it should have been, because it is a really beautiful song. Again, the kind of sections it goes through, you've got this kind of very it's more acoustic based, this track, but just McAloon's, like Paddy McAloon's vocal on it is just just stunning on it. And then you've got like this lovely like solo in it like as well, and if me it is again just a perfect faultless song which every time it's on I just like really like enjoy hearing. So yeah, for me, would be my favourite song of theirs. I suppose, like again, as I said, this list could change around, but I think it is fair song to have like at number one. I think it is a firm fan favourite there. So that's Bonnie from Steve McQueen. So thanks everyone for watching this video. I hope you have enjoyed it. And I would be interested to know what some of your favourite Prefab Sprout songs are. I am aware I probably have left off two of their biggest hit singles, from this list. When Love Breaks Down, which probably would come in about number 11, like number 12 for me. I don't like that song, so like that song's great. But then the other was The King of Rock and Roll, which was the biggest hit. And again, as I said, I've never really got on with that song like too well. I think it is just a bit, it's just a bit too silly for me. And I think a lot of their fans don't really like rate it too highly. It's a bit of a shame that was like their only really big big single. But yeah, a fantastic band there, like as you've seen like from like those 10 like excellent songs there. I would be interested to know what some of your favourites off theirs are. And I will see you all next time for the next video. Goodbye.